Hello, in this video, I will show you how your microservices can get access to the new exciting AI capabilities in the new Oracle 23 AI version. Of course, your AI microservices will be running in Kubernetes, and each microservice will have its own data store. This architecture is great for isolation, scalability, but introduce a new problem. We need to manage multiple data stores, so we need to take care of data security, patching, backup for all those data stores. Oracle Multitenant architecture could help to solve it. We have an isolated data store for each microservice. It is a pluggable database, or PDB, and it is like a container running in the database. And we have only one multi-tenant container database or CDB. So we have only one database to be managed. Great, it sounds good, but I don't want to be an Oracle expert in order to manage those PDBs. Well, the Oracle Database Operator for Kubernetes helps to simplify the PDB management. Of course, the operator can manage Oracle databases running as containers in the Kubernetes cluster, but it can also manage Oracle Database Cloud System and Autonomous Databases in OCI. And as we will see now, it can manage PDBs on top of any existing Oracle database, including our new Oracle 23 AI version. So we could have our microservices running in Kubernetes, consuming AI services from the Oracle 23 AI version, and managed by the Oracle Database Operator for Kubernetes. Let's see a quick demo about how to manage those PDBs from a Kubernetes cluster on top of the Oracle 23 AI version. Okay, so this is the database I'm going to use for this demo. It is running on OCI. As you can see here, it is a 23 version. Cool. I will check first the current PDBs we can find in the database. I have here, I already ran the command, so I will run it again so we can see that we have the PDB seed, that it is the default for any Oracle database. And this is the one I created when I provisioned the database using the OCI console. Good. So we can start working with the operator. I can go here and go, this is my operator folder. I'm going to use today the multi-tenants. And in the multi-tenants, I have a folder ready for use that it is EBN23. Here you will see I have different folders. The first one I'm going to use is the CDB one. So CDB. And in this CDB folder, what I'm going here is just to create the binding from the Oracle Database Operator for Kubernetes with my database running in OCI. Okay, what I need for that? I'm going to use a YAML descriptor, so we can take a look to the YAML. So I'm going to be my YAML, and here, this is my descriptor. I'm telling to my Kubernetes cluster that I'm going to create this CDB. This will be a CDB resource, of course, and I'm going to connect to a remote database using the service name. I will use the DB server address. And of course, in order to connect to remote database using REST API, I need to provision an Oracle REST Data Service instance. Okay, it will allow me to access to the remote database using the REST API from my Kubernetes cluster. So to do that, I need an ORTS Docker image that I have pulled to one of my Oracle repository, Oracle that container repository, sorry. So here is my the image I'm going to use, the pull policy, and this is the secret I'm going to use to connect to the container repository. And I will need some credentials in order to connect to the remote database, to configure the Oracle REST data service, and so on. So that's good. That's all what I need. So I think that we are ready to create the binding with the existing database. So let's go out from here and just kubectl apply from file, and I will use this descriptor. Okay, it is applying. It has been created. So what should I have here? Let me check kubectl get CDBs, and I will get it from the Oracle database operator system. Okay, this is one that I already have previously, and now it is provisioning my new CDB that it is still creating the pod. We can check the pods. So if I check the pods running on my operator namespace, then I will find that I have this Oracle REST data service for my 23 version. So let's check if the CDB is ready. Still waiting. We need to wait that validating the auth spot. It is ready, but a few seconds more. So it is creating the service. New stage. Still creating. I'm going to clear a little bit this screen. And hopefully we have ready our CDB to start working with our PDBs. Okay, it is ready. We can start working with the PDBs. Okay, so next in the CDB, I'm going to move to my PDB folder. So CDPDB. And here, remember that we are working with, for example, two microservices. We could have the inventory microservices and the order microservice. In this case, with the operator, I can do more than create. I can clone, I can delete, I can open, plug and plug, and so on. But in this demo, I will be focused only in the creation. So let's check what about my inventory PDB. So I'm going to use B inventory create. This is in the descriptor. Okay, so what I'm telling to the Kubernetes cluster here, I'm telling that I want to create a PDB. It will be the name of my PDB. And I'm going to use the CDB I have created in the previous step. So I have here the CDB resource I'm going to use for that. This is the CDB name that I create before. And this is the information about the PDB. It will be the PDB name and all the credentials I need in order to access to the remote database. And finally, I have here more information about the PDB I'm going to create. Cool, looks so simple that now I can try to create it. I'm going to quit it. And let's go to apply, kubectl, apply from file, and inventory create. Okay, we have that our PDB seems to be created. Okay, let's check it. Now, instead of get the CDBs, I'm going to ask for the PDBs. Okay, looks like I have my first PDB running. I have my inventory PDB. So let's look into the database if it is created in the same way. Okay, there is my inventory PDB. Cool. Here, as you can see, I can see my connection string, so my microservices can get this connection string, go to my Kubernetes secrets, retrieve the credentials I need to connect to the database, so my inventory microservices can start working with this BTP. I'm going to repeat with the order. Let's look to the order. It will be mainly the same. Again, we are working with the same CDB. And now I'm going to create the order BTP that will be for my second microservice. More or less the same information I have in the inventory one. So escape key here. And now I'm going to apply. Don't like to type, so I'm going to order create. Okay, so creating my order. Created. Good. So let's check if it is true. I'm going to list my PDBs. So I have my PDBs running. It is my first one, my inventory one is created. And we need to wait a little bit more just because the PDB has been created in database. A few seconds. And everything is ready. So let's look again to the database. Okay, I have again my order PDB and my inventory PDB. So I can start working with those data stores from my microservices. That's cool. Yeah, that's a very simple example about how you can use Oracle Database Operator to connect to our new database version and start consuming our incredible AI services included with the database. So I hope it helped. Bye.